I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A
thank you. for tonight begins with a quick summary of the first team to take home silverware on this incredibly successful year for the school. The all-conquering Year 8 boys team began training on a very wet and muddy pitch at the end of September. And if I'm being honest, coming off the pitch that day, Martin and I were not overly confident. But after a switch to the all-weather pitch and firmer ground, the true ability of these boys began to show. After playing a number of friendlies in the Tyrone Blitz, all attention focused on the Oisin McGrath Year 8 Blitz with Ulster Sports Arena. After some great performances, we qualified unbeaten on top of the group, which resulted in a quarter-final draw and a big win against Our Lady and St Patrick's Knock, followed by a semi-final win over St Pius's, which was a much tighter affair. That put the boys in the Oisin McGrath final against St Mary's Belfast in Argyll. And a brilliant performance on the day returned the trophy to Holy Trinity College. After a couple of months off, we were back out training again, playing in many of the blitzes that we had been invited to, trying to get as many players as possible the opportunity to play as many minutes as we could get them. This was ideal preparation for the McQuillan Cup, which was won only 2 weeks ago on a very warm Friday in Belfast. Great wins against St Mary's Belfast, St Louis Ballymena and St Paul's Base Group allowed the boys to qualify for the final, where they again got the better of our new rival St Mary's Belfast, and captain Michael McElhattan lifted the second Ulster title of the year, a first for any Holy Trinity team. The dedication of this group of players has been amazing. Their work rate at training and in games allowed them to achieve the success that they have. In the Oisin McGrath campaign, they averaged 11 blocks per game. For any team, but especially Year 8 team, that is an incredible statistic. They were willing to work harder than any opponent they faced this year. Martin and I would like to take this opportunity to thank the clubs for all the work that they have done and continue to do with the boys. To all the staff within the school, if you helped us in any way, we could not be successful without your support. To our generous sponsors for your continued support, and to the parents and guardians who collect the boys after training, usually in the dark, wash the monkey kits and make sure they have packed lunches and their football boots in their bags before they go anywhere. Again, we cannot do this without your help. On the first day, Martin and I joked that we were taking our first Hogan Cup winning training session. After this year, with this group of players, anything's possible. Thank you and enjoy the rest of the day.
Thank you, Master O'Neill. To make the presentation tonight, we're very fortunate we have two highly esteemed members of the Ulster Schools Committee. One of them's from Armagh, and one of them's from Tyrone. One of them does all the talking, and one of them does all the hard work. So the man that does the talking is from Armagh, and Mr. Jimmy Smith, could you come up to the stage, please? Before Jimmy says a few words, we'll make the presentation of our captain and vice-captain of the Year 8 team, Owen Canavan and Michael McElhattan, if you could come up to receive your two awards. Thank you.
For the county and the whole of the province of Ulster. It's wonderful to see any school winning a provincial title, but to go on and prove your calibre by going on to lift an All-Ireland title marks you out as something special. I've been fortunate to be linked with Holy Trinity for quite a few years. I had the honour of presenting the medals to the 1998 team, which included Gavin Devlin and Owen Mulligan, who had all the collect All-Ireland medals. And in 2012, I was in Croke Park the day that he lifted the All-Ireland again. Two of those boys went on to win All-Ireland under 21 medals, and the six of them had made their way under the Tyrone senior squad. It's a great bonus that for young first years, they have done so well to collect the Danske Bank Ashley McGrath and the Danske Bank McCullen Cup, because they don't need to look very far for their heroes. Just have a look at the photographs on the corridor, where they see all the players who went before them and have done so well, not only for their counties, but as well as that, and as important as that, for their clubs. And if they need more heroes, then they just need to look into the classrooms. And it's the teachers in the classroom who, Mrs. Russell said, who do the unheralded, unseen work, who give of their time voluntarily, and their cars are the last ones out of the car park. And if they're very fortunate, then they have the good fortune to see their team coming to the end of the trail and collecting the cup. The McLaren Cup winners and the Tommy Drummond winners certainly have provided lessons for not only the young players in the school, but for all the rest of the schools in Ulster, because they never give up. They were out of it in the McLaren final on St Patrick's Day and got a second chance. They were out of it in Celtic Park and Derry, and their fullback sailed up the field and struck the ball over the bar. And in the All Ireland semi final, I was on one side of the pitch and getting reports from Kevin Kelly as to how Billy Trinity were getting on the other pitch. And it was all bad stories. And he told me, I think it was 10 points behind. And then they phoned me back at half time and said they're leading. And they never looked back. So that team marked themselves out as a team of character, a team of pedigree, and a team that can give lessons to the young year racing school. And that is, never give up. You just need one chance, and if your name is on a cup, then if you're going to be that team, you will. So to the Drummond team, congratulations. And to the winners of the Ashley McGrath and the McCullen Cup, you have a future ahead of you in the school, and I'm quite sure part of the plans for the new build is a trophy room.
A performer tonight who is a past pupil. She will be the Tyrone representative in the Rose of Tralee in August. And she's going to perform tonight. Her name is Ellen Campbell. Thank you. Accompanied by Joe Neeson and Darren Neeson, and as our special guest tonight is from Dublin, Mr. Horn, this is for you.
Thank you. Angel.